I think in the past 5 years, I've worked with over 150 brides in all different capacities, so I've seen a lot. Once you get engaged, the stress piles on. You ask your friends to be bridesmaids, to be a maid of honor, and then you overwhelm them with things you want them to do that cost them money, that make them stressed, that make them exhausted. Some of the packages that I offer for maid of honors is a maid of honor speech writing package. People will come to me, they'll tell me all about their relationship with the bride, and I'll write their maid of honor speech for them. And for the bride, I have a couple of different packages. One is the vent session where you can come to me and I'll be there for honest advice. And then the rest are being a bridesmaid for hire, being there in person, whether it's for your bachelorette party, your bridal shower, or your wedding. 5 minutes before the ceremony, the bride grabs me by the arm, sticks me in a room, locks the door, and tells me, "Jen, I hate the groom." And I looked at her and I said, "Okay, you wanna leave? I'll call an Uber, we'll get pizza, it's all good. But before we do that, you have to speak to him." So I locked them in a room, I closed the door, I put a timer on my phone for 10 minutes, I told the priest, like, "You gotta back off a little bit." And after 10 minutes, they came out. And she said to me, "Look, we both come to an agreement that this isn't gonna work, but we're gonna go through with it. We're gonna pretend to get married, and after the wedding ends, we'll figure it out." The universe did not agree with this woman because everything went completely wrong. It poured so badly that the water from the tent made the tent fold in and it was just soaking wet. When they went to move her cake, the table broke and the cake flew up in the air and went everywhere. It was as if everyone was saying, "Why are you doing this?" When I'm hired, I am not always there in secret, but most of the time I am, which means I have a fake name, I have a fake backstory for how I know the bride, and oftentimes the bride doesn't tell anybody, not even the person she's marrying, that she hired me. Before I got into this business, I hated weddings. I still hate weddings. I think they're awful in the sense of, look, you're stressing out over an 8-hour thing. Big deal the flowers are the wrong color. Big deal your aunt isn't here yet. How are you gonna enjoy this party that you just drained your savings account for? The most foolproof technique is you face the wall, we pull up the dress, I use both arms to get all the dress in my hands, and you stand over the toilet and hopefully it happens. Usually it takes a couple minutes to happen. Usually we turn on the sink or I sing or I talk about whatever to make it happen, but it is a process. Somebody should invent like wedding day diapers for brides because it is a nightmare having to go to the bathroom. I once had a bride who hired me and she sat me down and said, "I need help ending my engagement." And I thought, well, this isn't really a package of mine, but you already paid me, so I guess I have to do this. And I sat there and I talked it through with her, and she hired me because she couldn't tell her friends and her family because they would talk her back into it. And I spoke to her for 2 hours. And we gave her a whole script of what she could say to him. And then I even said to her, like, "After you do it, come over to my apartment, you can stay there." I just felt so bad for her. And after 2 hours, she looked at me and she said, "Isn't it so weird how I suddenly really miss him? Like, I don't know, I think I kind of like miss him." And I thought to myself, good luck. Here's the script, here's the game plan, you go do what you're gonna do. I don't know if she ended up getting married or not. I didn't even have it in me to follow up. The bridesmaid is called her Princess Jessica. The groom wore a suit of armor, pretended to be a knight. The dogs walked down the aisle with their outfits. Not only that, but she also decided that she wanted to have 3 performances where she was singing. But the problem was the wedding was outdoors in Kansas in the summer and it was 150 degrees. Guests were leaving. The other issue was it was a dry wedding. Guests were leaving. And the other issue was she had 4 costume changes, which each took 30 minutes because the costumes were elaborate. By the time she did her second performance, there were 3 of 100 guests left. Everyone just left. I felt the sense of loneliness that we all sometimes feel, and the sense of wanting to stand out, wanting to put on the show for people when really they don't want the show, they want you. To all the bridesmaids out there who have to do this for free, you should say no. not to being a bridesmaid, but to doing all of these things that you're not getting paid to do, you can't afford, and you don't have time for. Nobody tells you when you're asked to be a bridesmaid that you can say no to things. If you can't go to Vegas because you know what, you have to work, or you can't afford it, don't go. If you can't buy that $300 bridesmaid dress, don't. And if they kick you out of the wedding, well then there's a huge friendship issue here that's bigger than this wedding experience.